पटेल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट एलजे इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन एंड कंट्रोल। टुडेज आवर टॉपिक इज मीमो सिस्टम, मल्टी इनपुट मल्टी आउटपुट सिस्टम इन द यूनिट नंबर 5, इंट्रोडक्शन टू मल्टी वेरिएबल सिस्टम। सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, व्हाट इज द मीमो सिस्टम? एज वी स्टडी इन द कंट्रोल सिस्टम, there is only a single input and single output closed loop system. Whatever input is given for this particular controller, we can get the particular output, and if output is not proper, we can connect the feedback element. Now our first topic in the chapter number 5 is control of multiple input multiple output processes. So the process interaction and the control loop interaction, because here we can apply the multiple input for this particular one system and we can get the multiple output. So interaction is the main thing for the process, and the control loop interaction is also important. Then we have to study the pairing of the control and the manipulate variable, because here multiple input is applied, so there are number of disturbance, there are multiple manipulate variable is there, and there are multiple controller is also there, because we have applied a different input signal. So we have continuous check the pairing of the controller and the manipulate variable. The third thing that we have to study is singular value analysis. If we can connect the multiple input for this particular system, it is good for this system or it is not for this particular system, that we have to analyze using the relative gain array and the singular value analysis. Then we have to tuning of multi-loop PID control system. The system is there, multiple input is applied, and we can get the multiple output. But as we discussed earlier, the output is not proper depending upon the input applied to this particular system. So that we have to tune this PID control system according to the controller system and according to the input applied to the system to get the proper or the perfect output. And then we have to use the decoupling and the multivariable control strategy. What is the decoupling? Suppose we have to use the 3 input for this particular system, but this 3 input is not necessary every time for this particular system. So that time we have to use the decoupling system. Using this technology, we can check one by one input for this particular system, and then we have to decide that which is the best pair for this particular system, and then we have to strategize for reducing control loop interaction. Suppose we have to use 4 input and the 4 output for this particular system. So there is a number of interruption, number of loop is there from input to output. Okay, so we have to strategize for reducing control loop, because whenever the number of loop is more, there is a number of error is generated for this process, and we cannot get the proper output depending upon the input signal. So we can try to reduce the control loop using the different interaction method, decoupling, RGA, singular value analysis, and then we have to design a best control system for this particular plant. Okay, so there are multiple points that we have to study in this chapter. So first of all, we know about what is the MIMO process. Okay, so control of multivariable process. So in practical control problems, that typically are the number of process variable which must be controlled and a number which can be manipulated. So example is there, product quality and throughput must usually be controlled. If we can use the control system for the product quality system, So continuous we can practically check the process variable. So here a physical example of the multivariable control problem is given. Here you can see that they will connect the liquid as well as gas, and here they will connect the LT and the PT. What is the LT? It is the level transmitter, and PT is the pressure transmitter, and it is the gas liquid separator system. Okay, so we can continuous check the pressure and the level controller using the pressure controller and the level controller, and then we can continuous examining the our output. So for that, first of all, this is the well known process where the single input U is applied, we can get the Y output. So this is the single input single output process with the multiple disturbances. As we study in the control system, input is applied, we can get output, but between the input and output we can get the multiple disturbance, noise, electrical interfaces. So this is the simple block diagram of the CISO signal or the single input single output process. Now if we can connect this single input single output process to the multiple input multiple output, so what is the diagram of this? So here multiple input is applied, U1 U2 up to UN, we can get the multiple output Y1 Y2 up to YN, and there are number of disturbances there to the process. So the diagram is multiple input multiple output processes. We have to apply N input and we can get the N output. Okay, so this is the multiple input multiple process. Here we can take only 2x2 MIMO process. Two input is applied for this particular process and we can get the two output. But here you can see that if two input is applied for this particular process, we can get many difficulty because there are so many disturbances applied in this process and we can get the output. So first of all, we know about what is the multivariable control, multivariables. So first one is the multi-loop control. Each manipulated variables depends on only a single control variables. That means a set of conventional feedback controller. So in the multi-loop control, each manipulated variable depends only one single control variable. What is the multivariable control? Each manipulated variable can depend more than one. That means can depend on two or more of the control variable. So this is the main difference between multi-loop and the multivariable control. In the multi-loop, the manipulated variable depends only of one single control variable, and in the multivariable control, each manipulated variable can depends on two or more of the control variables. Example is decoupling control, model predictive control. In that we have to use the multiple input. So there is a multiple manipulated variable. So we can use a multi-loop control system and the multivariable control system. Now control system design, we have used a select controller and the manipulated variable. Then we have to select the pairing of the controller and the manipulated variable. Then we have to specify the types of feedback controller. Then we have to check the output. So these are the steps whenever we design the control system design. First of all, we have to select the controller. If we will deal with the temperature system, so we can connect the temperature controller. Okay, then we have to select the pairing of the control and the manipulated variable. If we have to deal with the temperature as well as the flow controller, so and the third is the pressure controller. So we have to decide the exert pair of the temperature flow and pressure. We cannot connect the temperature controller, pressure controller, flow controller as it is. We can choose the pair of these controller, and then we have to specify the type of the feedback controller that is connected to this closed loop system. So example is 2x2 system, U1, U2, Y1, Y2, and process is given. So two possible controller pairing is there. First is U1 with Y1 and U2 with Y2 as it is. So it is 1-1-2-2 pairing system. But the possibility is there like U1 with Y2 and U2 with Y1. So it is known as the 1-2-2-1 pairing. Now which pairing is best for the multi-loop control system? So two control variables and two manipulated variables. That means we have to require four transfer functions. First one is the pairing is Y1 with U1, then Y1 with U2, Y2 with U1 and Y2 with U2. Y1 and Y2 is my output signal, U1 and U2 is my input signal. So what is the transfer function for Y1 and U1? So Y1S upon U1S, that is equal to GP11S. This is my first control variable. Then next, Y1S upon U2S, that is equal to GP12S. How you have to write the control? You can take Y1, that means GP1, and U2, that means 2 into S. If Y2S upon U1S, so that is equal to GP21S. Y2S upon U2S, that is equal to GP22S. Okay, now the input and output relation for the process can be written as, we have to find the value of Y1S first output and Y2S second output. So Y1S, that is equal to, depend on U1 and U2 as it is, because in the block diagram you can see that Y1 will be depend on U1 and U2. Y2 will be also depend on U1 and U2. So what is the equation of Y1? Y1 is equal to GP11S U1S and GP12 U2S. Y2S is equal to GP21 U1S and GP22 U2S. Now, actually equation of output is, output is equal to transfer function or the controller into input signal. So Y of S is equal to GP of S into U of S. Now what is the Y of S here? Two output is there. So Y of S is equal to Y1S, Y2S, U of S is equal to U1S, U2S, and GP of S is equal to, here four controller, GP11S, GP12S, GP21S, and GP22S. Clear? Now, here the actual block diagram of 1-1-2-2 controller pairing. Now, what is the 1-1-2-2 controller pairing? So, here you can see that 1-1-2-2 pairing, that means U1 input is applied with the Y1 and U2 with Y2. So what is the block diagram of 1-1-2-2 pairing? So here you can see that YSP1, that means set point 1, and YSP2, set point 2. Okay, output is fixed, Y1 and Y2. For Y1, input is U1. For Y2, input is U2. But here four control and manipulate variable. So we can take the pairing of these. Okay. We have two controllers, GC1 and GC2. So input is applied to the summing point GC1 and YSP2 is applied to the GC2. And E1 is the error signal for the first controller and E2 is the error signal of the second controller. Clear? After that, input is applied U1 and U2. Okay, U1 is connected both Y1 and Y2 depending upon this diagram equation. Y1 is equal to GP1 U1 U1S and G1 to U2S. So we can connect here Y1 that is equal to addition of GP12 and GP11. Same thing Y2 addition of GP21 and GP22 and U1 and U2 is connected both. So this is 1-1-2-2 control pairing. But the second pairing is here. U1 with Y2 is possible and U2 with Y1 is also possible. So this is my second block diagram of 1-2-2-1 controller pairing. So here, what is the changes? So here you can see that GC1 and GC2 will be connected different. GC2 will be connected with the YSP2 but with the U1. And GC1 is connected with the YSP1 but U2. The error signal is as it is. Now GP11, GP12, GP21 and GP22 as it is. But here Y2 will be summing with the GP22 and GP21 U1. Here you can see that Y2 is equal to GP22 U2 and GP21 U1. Y1 is equal to GP11 U2 and GP11 U1 and GP12 U2. So we can interchange the pairing U1 with Y2 and U2 with Y1. So this controller pairing is known as the 1-2-2-1. Here we can say or we can ask about only two multiple variables, two input and the two output. If we can change the input, if we have pairing with the three input with the three output, there are number of controller pairing will be more. So depending upon the process or the disturbance or the manipulator variable, we can change the controller pairing depending upon the application. Okay, so in this lecture we will study the different types of MIMO system that is used in the different application and how we can connect the controller with the different input and output. Thank you everyone. If anyone have doubt, then contact me in my email ID.